trophy, so she qualified for her 7th Grand Prix final, but for the first time ever, she didn't finish on the podium. So you know she has some unfinished business as well after making her return last season. A lot more things that she needs to perfect this year before heading into the Olympic year.
So much grace and poise. She's thrilled us with triple axels in the past. Don't believe there's one planned here. If there was, it would be here. Nope. Obviously just going for the double today. When you're competing at the age of 26, not, you know, a veteran, but at the same time, you do gather a lot of memories with you. How do you carry them? Are they becoming confident with you, or are they pulling you down? That's kind of where she is in her career right now.
So much finish, and that dress is stunning.
Unusual misfire on a simple jump, double axel. The bad news there was mostly that there was a planned jump after it. The technical difficulties piling up a little bit here. See if she can get it back.
Keep your eye on the technical tracker. It's showing you what the leader's got and what Maurer's racking up.
Jumping passes in a row with errors until finally landing that triple loop right there. Beautiful program, but technically in the last 60 seconds has kind of evaporated.
Yeah. And everything appeared to be going swimmingly.
Sure did.
It's nice and slippery, we've said it before.
Japan, a 6-time national champion and 2-time world champion. You know, she's in new territory here because last year her bronze at NHK Trophy, that ended her run of 6 straight first place finishes on the Grand Prix circuit. Wonder if she can regain that, but I don't know after that free skate.
She left so many points on the table with those three missed jumping passes because two of them were combination jumps that just completely disappeared. Oh,
she took herself out of it.
She did.
Too bad.
And here's a look at the replays now for the skeet of Mao Asada here at Skate America.
So what happens? You've got a great skater who's obviously knows how to win. And so I think it sometimes it's like you become self-aware halfway through the program. You might even get behind the music a little bit, or a step sort of catches you off guard and you become immediately self-aware. You get a little burst of adrenaline and all of a sudden your timing changes. And the timing is really everything in competition. Do you go down in the knee and pick and go up at the right time? Can't complain about that program though, can you?
No. Oh.
Well, Mao is going to need 122.16 to take the lead here from the Canadian, Gabby Dailman. As we get ready now for her marks, let's see if she can get it. And she will not, 112.31, so that'll keep her behind. So Gabby Dailman still holding on to the lead here early on at Skate America. Let's go back down now to Scott Russell with some updates.
Thanks very much, Andy. Lots more skate.